Take a moment to think about the appearance of a modern bird, like a parrot or something similar. We know these animals have relatively thick bodies, feathery coats, unique patterns, and varying colors. Now let's look at a parrot's skeleton. You'll notice that based on the bones alone, these birds seem like they'd have long, slender frames. Yet the layers of skin and feather coverings make them look quite different than their gaunt skeletal structures might suggest. And this exact phenomenon presents a practical challenge when it comes to reconstructing accurate depictions of dinosaurs. An increasing number of soft tissue discoveries have suggested that many, though not all, species of dinosaurs possess more feathers, layers of fat, and other unusual details than one might assume based on the outdated depictions many of us grew up with. The challenge of capturing the forgotten peculiarities of dinosaurs is at the center of all yesterdays, a book written and illustrated in part by C.M. Koseman, whose work you may recognize from his other most famous book, All Tomorrows. The 2012 speculative art book All Yesterdays was created not just by Koseman, however, but also Darren, Naish, an expert paleontologist and author, and John Conway, a skilled paleo artist. These three are brilliant, and I have links to where you can follow and support them in this video's description. Not long ago, I covered a section of this book titled All Todays, in which the authors imagine what might happen if, millions of years into the future, clueless alien scientists tried to recreate depictions of long-extinct organisms based solely on the fossil record, with pretty hilarious results. But I can't emphasize enough that, despite misconceptions to the contrary, All Yesterdays isn't trying to belittle the field of paleontology with these images, or suggest modern scientists are similarly clueless when it comes to reconstructing dinosaurs. Paleo art has come a long way, thanks in part to the efforts of these creators. The three authors, all of whom are deeply involved in the paleontology community themselves, make it clear that modern paleontologists aren't just blindly interpreting fossils, but also making great strides in integrating studies of feather impressions and soft tissue preservation to gain more complete pictures of what these incredible creatures might have looked like. However, like with any science, there are still, of course, a diversity of fascinating unknowns when it comes to dinosaurs, and All Yesterdays explores how speculation, as long as it's cautiously grounded in science, can both help and even play a vital role in showcasing the intriguing possibilities of how dinosaurs might have looked and behaved. All Yesterdays stresses a balance between caution and speculation, always pointing out that many of the reconstructions within the pages might be completely off the mark. That's just the nature of speculation. With that said, let's get started and take a closer look at what unique aspects of dinosaurs may not show up in the fossil record. The first out-of-the-norm reconstruction of a dinosaur All Yesterdays explores is of a Carnotaurus, drawn at a unique angle by John Conway. While the bull-headed predators are usually depicted from the side, here the authors depict the animal head-on, drawing attention to just how strange the animal looks, with its arms stuck out to the side in a bizarre display. The idea behind this strange spectacle comes from the animal's skeleton, which shows the animal had stunted, ineffectual arms yet possessed unique shoulders, which would have allowed the animals to spread these arms out sideways in a way utterly dissimilar to other large predatory dinosaurs, an ability which seems to serve no practical purpose. So, the authors imagine the arms on the Carnotaurus and the related Majungasaurus, pictured here in C.M. Koseman's one-of-a-kind style, were waved about in mating or territorial displays, potentially alongside bright colors, not unlike many birds today. A bizarre concept for sure, but not altogether improbable given the available paleontological data. Of course, some dinosaur colors might have also gone in the opposite direction. Can you see the Majungasaurus in this image? How about now? Here, the authors explore the possibility that some dinosaurs might have had appearances which supported camouflage and mimicry, blending into the natural features of the environment much like a modern stick bug. Now, it's usually smaller animals, not predators like Majungasaurus, which employ camouflage, but some large modern predators' body patterns, like the tiger's distinctive stripes which allow them to blend into tall grasses, do help them ambush prey, so it's certainly possible some dinosaurs might have had similar camouflaged appearances. Here's another recreation which, at first, might be difficult to see. This is All Yesterday's speculative concept for a Plesiosauria, portraying the animal with impressive camouflage. Strange though this might seem to anyone familiar with traditional portrayals of Plesiosauria, the modern oceans are swarming with remarkable forms of mimicry. Just look at the incredible appearance of something like a leafy sea dragon, and you'll start to understand just how amazing past ocean life might have looked. Now, the authors aren't actually making a scientific assertion that this is what all Plesiosauria, which for the record weren't actually dinosaurs but adjacent marine reptiles, looked like. Most Plesiosauria likely had smooth skin for better hydrodynamics. But it's not impossible some branches tried an ambush approach, which may have favored better camouflage. An interesting possibility for sure. Back on land, here's a quite heavily feathered speculative reinvention of a Therizinosaurus. The Therizinosaurus looked quite menacing based on its skeleton alone, thanks to the animal's absurdly long claws, which in the past excited artists and caused them to make overly deadly looking animals, despite the fact the animal wasn't a predator. The thick layer of feathers certainly makes the animal look less frightening, and quite different from their skeletal appearance. If you compare the gaunt skeleton of, say, an owl, however, to the quite different shape of the actual bird, you can start to see how such a difference between skeleton and body size isn't too crazy a concept. Therizinosaurus skeletons also have wide hips, so it's been theorized they have sizable physiques. Beyond proto-feathers, All Yesterdays also explores the hypothetical that some dinosaurs, like Heterodontosaurus, might have had defensive quill-like structures, not unlike the defense of the modern porcupine. Seems hard to believe? Well, a recently exceptionally well-preserved specimen of the early Ceratopsian Psittacosaurus was found with bristle-like quills on its tail. The Psittacosaurus is actually one of the most completely reconstructed dinosaurs, and its appearance is certainly not tame. Paleontologists don't think those strange bristles on its tail were for self-defense, but it's certainly possible that some genuses, like Heterodontosaurus, which we also now know had some kind of spike-like dermal quills, could have used their bristles for self-defense. Going even further into hypothetical territory regarding proto-feathers, the authors imagine a group of Leaellynasauria amicographica as round furballs, quite different from the popular notion of a dinosaur. Far from fanciful speculation, however, the author's recreation is based on evidence that the Leaellynasauria lived in a near-polar region, and almost certainly had to endure sub-zero temperatures. While one might look at such a reconstruction and think it looks too adorable for a dinosaur, the authors point out that the hesitancy around depicting dinosaurs as cute is potentially an overly limiting one. Also incorporated into this design, Leaellynasauria tails were almost three times as long as their body, for reasons paleontologists aren't quite certain of. All Yesterdays depicts their tails as strange, flagpole-like tools for social displays. While easy to dismiss this concept as overly speculative, the authors point out that while it's certainly unlikely, it's only so much weirder than what you might see anywhere else in nature. But appearance is only one half of the speculative puzzle when it comes to dinosaurs. The authors observe that various unique behaviors likely weren't preserved within the fossil record. Just think about the mating dances of birds of paradise, the unique calls of whales, or even something as simple as the dung rolling of dung beetles, and you'll start to realize that behaviors which give animals huge parts of their identity can often not be understood from remains alone. And it stands to reason some dinosaurs might have had similarly bizarre behaviors which fall into the same category. Here's an intriguing speculative example of Elasmosaurus, marine reptiles which also aren't actually dinosaurs, behaving in a highly unusual manner. Here, the authors invent a scenario where the Elasmosaurus lunge out of the depth and wave their necks, competing to prove who is the strongest. Older art of Elasmosaurus sometimes shows them holding their necks above the water's surface with ease. But modern paleontology has proven these animals had heavy bones and denser necks, which could only be lifted out of the water with significant effort. So the author imagines these dinosaurs exerting such a strain as a form of social competition. Of course, this is absolutely and unapologetically speculative, yet equivalently remarkable behavior is likely lost somewhere in our past. In a similar vein of speculative thought, here the authors imagine Protoceratops engaging in a tree-climbing behavior there's no direct evidence for in the slightest. And yet, certain breeds of goats also climb trees, a strange-looking behavior you wouldn't guess the hoofed mammals would engage in based on their body plans alone. And yes, these modern goats, they are not a hoax, they truly hang out in trees. It's something like this sort of unexpected conduct which might be absent from the fossil record. On the subject of dinosaurs doing things they're not known for, playing is certainly a significant example. Instead of showing a dinosaur striking a pose or getting attacked by a predator, this recreation shows a Camarasaurus enjoying a simple roll in the mud. Speculative though this may seem, almost all living animals engage in some form of play, both larger mammals but also various species of birds, reptiles, and even fish. Most animals have been observed taking part in behavior for no practical reason other than it seems to be fun. So dinosaurs, even if they're sometimes thought of creatures that lived in constant battle with one another, almost certainly engage in playful behavior too. And here at the end is an image which, despite its simplicity, is one of the hardest to process. It shows a T-Rex just sleeping in a peaceful field. But so much of our classic perception of the creature is of a roaring monster with its jaws agape ready to strike, that we forget the Tyrannosaurus is also just an animal. And animals sleep, especially hunting animals, who need to conserve energy and therefore spend a considerable amount of time resting. It's not certain if T-Rexes slept on their sides or not, or if they had this particular coloration, but it's still an intriguing image that gets the viewer to think of the animal as more than just a machine of death. Ultimately, science and speculation aren't concepts in opposition to each other. All paleontological art of long-extinct creatures is speculative to some degree, and thinking about interesting, albeit unusual, possibilities can help us appreciate all we know and don't know about these remarkable animals from the distant past. And that's the end of our glimpse at the intriguing All Yesterdays. If you like this content, please consider supporting Koseman, Naish, and Conway's work by purchasing a copy of the book, and by patronizing their other works and social media, which, as always, you can find in the links below. Also, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this entry, please lend your support, and like, subscribe, and hit the notification icon to stay up to date on all things curious. See you in the next video.